Good morning, everybody. Welcome to chapel. Today is a great day because we are here to hear God's word and sing his praise. And we are going to begin this morning by singing about how Jesus is always with us in the morning, the noontime, and when the sun goes down. And all the things we can do with Jesus in that same time allotment. Will you please stand and sing with me?
Spirit. Broken by sin and defeated by death, we are in desperate need of God's help. The Almighty and Merciful God, forgive us all our sins and lead us into eternal life. Be strong in the Lord and in his strength.
Put on the whole armor of God and stand firm.
In the midst of Satan's lies,
put on the belt of truth.
When we struggle to live up to God's expectations, when we are reluctant to share the good news,
fill our feet with the gospel of peace.
When we doubt God's goodness,
take up the shield of faith.
When we are weighed down with guilt,
put on the helmet of salvation.
When we are under attack,
take up the sword of the Spirit.
When God places upon us his holy armor,
you may have a seat.
Strength that God has given. that was not a very enthusiastic good morning. And I know not all of you can visit the blessed bean and get that caffeine high, but good morning.
Good morning.
All righty. So first of all, this chapel has been done before, but I'm wondering if we ever listen to Bible verses more than once, or if we ever rewatch TV shows or reread a good book. Raise your hand if you've ever rewatched a show you really like, listen to a Bible verse more than once. All right, so then I know that we can still be good listeners today. Also, this is from 2019, which was from before the pandemic, which seems like years ago. So we're going to talk about something that some people know a lot about and some people don't, and that's okay. But I know that the message will, I know that the Holy Spirit will still work in your hearts. So will you pray with me real quick? Dear Jesus, work in my heart this morning to be a good listener and use your word in battle. Amen. All right, I'll take the first slide. So you guys are going to help me, and some of you are going to have a large knowledge base and some of you are not, and that's okay. All right, so we're going to play Who's That Pokemon? All right, I see one up here. I see some hands, and there's going to be a lot of you that know it, so you can just say it. Who is this Pokemon?
Bulbasaur.
Okay, now, there are types with Pokemon, and then there are attacks. So the attack is how they defeat their enemies, right? And we see Vine Whip. Okay? I won't be using a Vine Whip today. Kyler, can you tell me a little bit about how do you defeat with a Vine Whip?
So it's like out of Bulbasaur's like big back, two giant whips whip.
Okay. All right, so this is an attack that Bulbasaur uses. All right, next one. Who's that Pokemon? You know, we should say it like they do in the show. Who's that? Okay, all right. Just say it. 1, 2, 3.
Squirtle.
All right, this is Squirtle. All right, he's a water type, and his attack is a water gun. Raise your hand if you're ready to attack with water guns. All right. So we're going to say it as it comes up and try to say it if you've seen the show the same way they say it on the show. Ready? Here we go. Here's the next one.
Who's that Pokemon?
All right. So, all right, we're going to say it on three. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Charmander.
Okay. His type is fire, and Gunner had his hand up earlier, and you had it up so nicely. Can you tell me about this attack? Oh, in the microphone.
So he breathes fire out his mouth, and yeah.
Sometimes by 3:20, I feel like I could breathe fire out of my mouth. Not a really great way either, okay? All right, I think there's one or two more, okay? Oh, let's say Heather. All right, say it, everyone. I know, everyone loves. There's something about that yellow creature that does bring joy to a lot of people, all right? So I'm going to wait. We're going to have to pause to be good listeners, because if we're excited and we don't hear God's word, then that wasn't what was supposed to happen today. So on the count of three, our voices are going to go off. 1, 2, 3. Awesome. And we see that he uses electric type, okay? We have another one, so.
Who's that?
Pokemon.
An eighth grader in the front. He's gonna do the talking now.
Who is it?
That's Evie.
Okay, and what type is she?
Normal.
And what's her attack?
Tackle.
Okay.
Alrighty. Let's see what's next up on that screen. Oh, okay. I got a fourth grader over here, so here we go.
Rockruff.
Okay. What type is he?
Rock. Rock throw.
Now, we know that only if you're Goliath or David, you're going to throw rocks, because we shouldn't throw rocks, especially at school. But that's his attack. So all these Pokemon, maybe go one more slide. Can't remember. Oh, we'll go back because I'm not a Pokemon. So all these Pokemon have a type and they have an attack. Say type. Say attack. All right, so we're going to put my picture up there. It's from a while ago, okay? So what's my type? Human. Just say it. Well, thanks, Ethan. Okay, Amos. teacher. So I'm going to go by a different type. Okay? You don't get an answer. Okay, go ahead and put it up there, please. My type is Christian. What's my type?
Christian.
And what's my attack?
God's word.
And you know what? I don't always use God's word. Last week, I was feeling kind of down, so I went into my old computer and I thought, maybe the website Shein, I can get some new clothes. That would be an attack that will make me feel better. Or maybe I'll just drink some more caffeine, and that can be my attack. And I usually just kind of end up feeling super anxious and jittery. Or sometimes, do you guys ever just binge watch on TV if you just want to like zone out from the world? Yeah? Maybe you ignore some things that are bothering you, like homework or a conversation you have to have. So I would say in the last 2 weeks, I haven't been using my attack like I should. And so I'd say the last 3 days, I've been trying to pray a lot more, and everything that comes up is about the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, and how the Holy Spirit will help you. So can we go to the next slide? So this is from Hebrews, and I want us to read it together because it's fun to look at the Pokemon and talk about fire attack and water type and rock throwing, but this is real stuff. We're at war. Who are we at war against? The devil, the world, and our own sinful flesh. The devil likes to tempt us. The world likes to say, hey, if you do some online shopping, you're going to feel better. And you do for a little while. And then our own sinful flesh, sometimes I'm just, because I'm sinful. Let's read this Bible verse together. Here we go. And so I'm not a Pokemon, and neither are you. But God does not leave us alone. He gives us an attack. And it doesn't seem fancy. It isn't as fun as sparkly new clothes or watching a fun new show. But it's the truth. And if you're an eighth grader, will you stand up? So these guys are getting ready. They're going to move on to different places. And they're going to be under attack. And you know what? Sometimes Satan likes to work double time on the people that are doing his work. And so don't be afraid if you feel that. And you know that you can use what? God's word. Also, the end of the school year, you guys can sit down. The end of the school year, I feel like we feel attacked more because we start to think, oh, I don't think the rules still apply to me. That was just in September, right? Do they still apply, Silas? So we've been talking all year about this. We're going to talk about this poster, and then we're going to move on. We have all these parts of the armor of God that can help us. And so when we feel weak, we know that we can attack with what? What are we going to attack with? God's word. What are we going to attack with?
God.
Now you're going to shout it. What are we going to attack with?
God.
And do you know that when you're struggling, you can ask your teachers or your friends to pray for you? I know a lot of you older kids have cell phones. You can send out a text and say, hey, I'm really struggling with this. Will you pray for me? And a lot of the adults in your life, they would love to get a text like that. I saw a junior come through the pickup line this morning that used to go to school here on the Blessed Fiend. And it made my heart so happy to see him go through the line and say, hey, do you have any prayer requests? And so your teachers, even after you're gone here, they still want to see you. They still want to hear from you. So we're going to attack with what? Oh, everybody needs to sit up. Some of you guys are looking to sleep. Come on. I know it's hard this time of year. Sit up, man. Okay? We're going to attack with what? And we're going to suit up and
stand.
All right. And Mr. Whitney deserves a thank you because he put that chapel together for me quite a few years ago. I think he's a Pokemon fan too. I mean, it's been around a lot of years.
Yeah, you all weren't even alive when Pokemon was a thing, so you don't know like I know.
Oh, so let's finish up with a prayer, okay? Repeat after me here.
Dear Jesus,
help me attack with God's word. And when I fail, I know that you forgive me. Amen.
Thank you, Mrs. Annan, for sharing about the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. We are going to get into our time of offering for this month. Would somebody please remind us in a nice, loud voice where our offerings are going? Silas Lewis, Camp Luther, that is right. Our money will help go to Camp Luther to help them pay some of their bills, help them get ready for camp so that when all the kids come this summer, they are ready to share the gospel with them. While the offering is being collected, we are going to sing a song. Acolytes and ushers, go get the plates and let us sing.
Please join me in the Apostles' Creed. Almighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put upon ourselves the armor of light now in the time of this mortal life, in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that on the last day, when he shall come again in glorious majesty to judge both the living and the dead, we may rise to life immortal through Jesus Christ our Lord. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Please join me in Luther's morning prayer. The strength and power of God the Father, the love and mercy of Jesus Christ, and the help of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Put on the whole armor of God.
Our closing song today is a throwback to a long time ago, but not so long ago that Mrs. Erickson doesn't know the song. This song has actions, and so we're going to follow along with the actions on the screen as it plays. So please join us in the closing song.
You may have a seat. Mrs. Onan, that's a hard act to follow. I don't have a tail whip or fireballs or anything like that. I'm not a Pokemon, so I got nothing. But I want to say thank you to Mrs. Onan for leading us in chapel, and then also thank you to our 8th grade, 7th and 8th grade leaders. You probably don't know this. This is the last time we will be here for chapel until closing chapel, very end of school. Because next week we don't have chapel on Wednesday. We have a prayer walk on Thursday instead. And then on field day, we'll be in the gym real briefly for like 20 minutes for a real quick chapel. And then closing chapel will be back here. So this is the last chapel here. So I want to say a special thanks to Mrs. On for leading us, but also to all of our 7th and 8th grade leaders that have been awesome helping lead us all year long. So help me thank them. ST! Thank you. Then we had a couple third graders that helped put away headphones and computers after they're left out after the kickball game. Gus Priner, Coleman Anderson, Kyler Onan, and Barrett Priner. Come on up. Thank you for showing how you're suited up to stand firm by putting others first and taking your time to clean up. Help me thank them. ST! You guys can have a seat. Big, big house. It's kind of a funny thing to sing about, isn't it? Yeah, especially in chapel. Why are we singing about a big house? Anybody know why we're singing about a big house in chapel? What do you think, Wyatt? Because of heaven. Jesus invites us, right? Absolutely. We have our plant sale still going on, and that's going to back playground equipment and kindergarten, first grade, preschool water fountains and outdoor classroom, and then we're tithing to Mrs. Kolbaum's mom's memorial. So I need not Sawyer, not Taylor, McKenna Schnitzler to help me out. Make sure you're not peeking, lady. No peeking. Can you read what it says?
Braxton and Brinley Anderson.
Braxton and Brinley Anderson. So they may find Mrs. Heller and grab something out of the concession stand. We have any other announcements? 10:30, we have jazz band and show choir in the gym. And then at 2 o'clock, we have our food and drink fair. So not a whole lot of time today to work hard, but we want you to work hard while you can. Otherwise, please come on up, acolytes and ushers.